Hi and welcome. My name is Lotte and this is Made of Yarn podcast. I'm coming from Sweden and this is about knitting today. I don't have any crochet to show you. And perhaps some yarn. I just recorded in Swedish and I told them that I made some interviews with a local yarn store here. But it's just in English, so perhaps I just show you some sequences from it and the surroundings. But I can show you, they had in August, they had a catwalk. Is it so? Also when they are showing sweaters, knitted stuff. They have once a year, they have this, they call it the farmer on the village something. It's a smaller place called Kilafors. It's 25 kilometers about from me here. And they have once a year the farm, so they have this, have marketplaces, they have horse riding for the children, and they have some local food. They call, I don't know how to describe it, it's called in Swedish kolbullar. Kol is like charcoal, so that because they have it like on a barbecue, but they make like a batter like a pancake, but it's not, they don't have any eggs in. It's just flour and water, salt, I presume, and how do you say that? I mean, like bacon, but not quite, but thicker bits. They fry that first in a pan and then it get quite greasy and fat, and then they pour the batter on that and turn it, and to that you will drink like a lemonade from lingonberries, and you have also lingonberry jam to it, and it's so good. Back in the days they said that this was the food for those who worked on the railway to prepare for the railway, so they built it, so to say. So they worked hard, so they needed this with much carbs and much fat in it, so they kept the energy up and they were full. you are satisfied and you don't want to eat for until the next day when you don't work. But it's so good. My two of my children were there, and my son had his girlfriend, and they said it was the tastiest they ever have eaten. Interesting, isn't it? Flour and water can be so good. So when I was there on the catwalk, they were around in this village to look around. It really small village, but they do so much fun things. Even the local grocery stores have extra things going on, and they have flour mills. Oh, they as not the mills, but they have flour to buy from local mills and so on. And yeah, like they have in markets in autumn. So I will show you, but long story to say that I will show you a film from that. So this, today I will perhaps not talk that much that I usually do, but I will show you some films from that. Also from another place, just 1 kilometer from that area. Sorry. Called Filtmakeriet. I've shown it before also here. They have a meal. No. They have a... Yeah, is it mill? They make wool. a tired brain again. This sweater is from that area, from Filtmakeriet. It's finished. It's the Wilfreda sweater from the Norwegian designer. I don't know if you see. Wenche Roald. So I knitted this in 1 ply with this pre-yarn, unspun yarn from Filtmakeriet. It's black tweed yarn, and 1 ply with the Eastex Einband, the thinnest they have. And it's lovely. I made it a little bit longer than in the pattern, but it's light and airy, so I like it. So it's a local, if you don't think about the Eastex that come from Iceland. So it's a local yarn. I will also put in here, so I made from leftovers for my boy's son's girlfriend Charlotte. I made her cardigan. It's called Martal. It's kind of a pine tree. The whole cardigan is in this one, and in the the purple thing, I can't say what it is. Rauma finol and 1 thread. Järbo silk mohair in that one. I gave it to her, so that's why I filmed a little bit for you. I'm looking at my notes. I will also it's a mix between everything. I will show you what I'm knitting on now. If you've been here before, I talked about I test knit a lot, and I still have it. It's the granny, I think it's called granny cardigan from Hohi Locatelli. She released it, the pattern, yesterday, I think it was, but I didn't finish it. I talked to her about it, and it was no problem, because I have problems now and then with ache. I have a ache all the time, but sometimes it's more. I couldn't, because it's cables, and I also had another from a Swedish designer, a sock with thinner needles, and I couldn't do that either. But it was okay with both of them. So I will finish them in my own time. So what I'm knitting on right now here, it's first time for me actually with this Drops Air. Can you see it? I have a new phone, so I don't know how the focus is. It's baby alpaca and merino wool, because my daughter Lovisa, she is so sensitive to ordinary wool, sheep wool. Merino is okay, and I tried this with baby alpaca. So she wanted a slip over. You can't see much of it, but it's it's from down up, and I'm working now on the, I don't know if it's the front, I guess it's the front, just the around neck end. I will show it when it's finished. So this is okay with just plain stockinette bigger needles for the moment. And then I also, what's here? I'm knitting for my brother's granddaughter, Daisy. She's three. She's also so sensitive to wool. And also her brothers and her mother. So that I heard it was a store, here in my town who had some sales. Oh, I pulled up, so I can fix that later. So I bought some yarn that is mostly actually acrylic in. It's called Moa. It's acrylic and some wool and some mohair. But sometimes I thought, what can I do if she can't? She loves what I'm knitting, the little one. But when it's too itchy, it's sad. So I bought this one. When it's directly on the body, at least. No, upside down. This is a pattern called Trollunge Dress. Troll Kid Dress, something. It's from the Finnish designer Lykke Liten, Victoria Snellman. She's a Finnish-Swedish designer. This will be a dress, a longer dress, a warm one. In her pattern, the sleeves are like trumpet shape more, but I think I will, because now it will be for the winter, so it's perhaps not easy to have a jacket outside, so I think I will just make them like that, but then like a balloon. So I will make them smaller in the wrist here, and then it will be you here in the back. You will crochet the buttonholes. I made some wrong here, but I think I will do it. Should have been garter stitch, but I already forgot what this is, stockinette. So perhaps I then will just make an eye cord around here, or perhaps also in the end on the sleeves. That's something of what I'm working on right now. I'm working on some socks also for her and her brothers. If you're looking here, if you can see this, I talked many times about making this year temperature blankets. This one was the one I started. I was working on two, one knitted and one that I'm crocheting. But I ended this one because I can't stand the mix of colors. This one is the colder for last winter and spring. And here came the summer. I can't stand the mix. It's too much going on between these ones. I can't. And also because if I should have continued, it would be been 3 meters long perhaps, and just 1 meter. I didn't think when I started this one. So this will be on my chair that I have in the bedroom perhaps, or just like a shawl or a blanket for my niece, or perhaps for a gift for a child, perhaps something. Looking again here. I talked about mostly everything. Last time, I hope I mentioned that October 7th, Pia Trans, who has the she's a designer, and also she has the podcast on YouTube, 50 Fabulous Knits, a Danish designer. For the fourth time, she will have this knit-a-ton. You knit if you can, or crochet or whatever, something handicraft, or you just can watch, because she, for 24 hours, because she have talked to some designers, and some also who have, but at least last time, who have yarn stores here and there. So it will be both in Danish, but mostly it will be in English. So we have, if we, about an hour each. I'm here for the second time. The first time was in April. So it's so fun. So I will have it. We will see it also later on here on YouTube, coming up. So I will have, in Central European time, it's 6 p.m. I don't know what it is where you live. So you're also welcome to participate by watching, and you can then also you can when you if you're there when it's live, sorry, you can chat and talk also. So I hopefully can see. It was so fun the last time. It was really, really fun. It was about 900 something who watched at the same time. I was so nervous first if it should work at all, and it did. And I was then nervous should anyone look at me at all, and it was, they did, I mean, and everyone was so nice. It was so lovely. So I'm so glad that Pia asked again if I wanted to participate again. So I will leave you now, but don't forget to check then the movies that I, it's not that much. I'm sorry, it will be a very short episode this time. Also, I see 17 minutes just about. But if you in October 7th, it will be an hour, I guess, if you can be there. And if you can't be live, you can look at it afterwards. If you check on my YouTube channel, you have different to see if I can take it up and show you. Wait a second. Here. Can you see? So you have this. Here you can click on videos. Here is shorts, and there is live. Can you see? So here you can see the live, and then you can. Sorry, it's like a mirror. But you can see the one that I had last time. If you like to watch it afterwards, so you can do it the same. I mean, here if you don't have the time to, or it's the wrong time if you're asleep, so you can see it afterwards also. I wish you the best, and I'm so grateful that you visited me here in my home on my porch. I hope it's not the last time, but perhaps it is. It's the end of September, and it has been a warm September, really lovely. And also, thank you for thank you for all who is subscribing. And if you don't, please do if you like. If you like what I'm making here, I'm so grateful if you like to subscribe also. And you know, this thumbs up and everything, it helps us YouTuber to be seen. It's not easy to when it's we are so many knitting podcasts, and we disappear among each other many times also. We smaller ones. Thank you so much. I wish you the best. Bye. Until next time. Here is just before it all started. I filmed a little bit around here, us waiting. It was a lovely day in August.
Thank you. Ringa vägen. Ingen fara. Jag har 8 stycken och de kostar 27 kronor styck. Ja.
Now I will take you to a mill 1K from this yarn store. vacker syn.
Ja, och jag var på
catwalk
i Wilfreda. Inte, men just nu hittade jag en sån vanligaste kofta, lerringad, sån som man ska ha istället för morgonrock. Och tänkte, stycken 4,5 och 18 masker på 10 cm faktiskt. Små dam.